We typically report the results of one-way ANOVA like this. Our F statistic as a function of our 2 degrees of freedom, between and within, our p-value, and eta squared. Note that when we're doing ANOVA by hand, we can't find the exact p-value. This is the same as with the t-tests. We only know that our p-value is less than 0.05, our alpha level, because our F statistic is greater than the F critical value. If we're using software, it'll be the same thing, except we can calculate the exact p-value. Notice that we've frequently used small samples in our examples and problem sets. However, we wouldn't normally use such small samples, especially in real research. But if we use large samples, we can't do ANOVA by hand. That would just take too long. We would use software instead. When we use software, we don't care as much about the intermediate steps. Really, we just want to compare the p-value with alpha. We know that if p is less than alpha, we'll reject the null. Since using software is so essential to doing statistical tests, we're going to provide you with some software output for you to see and analyze so that you get familiar with it. This is real data that Dr. Laraway collected from his psychology students at San Jose State University. There are 188 students total, 90 of which were freshmen, 44 sophomores, 23 juniors, and 31 seniors. And he asked them to self-report how many days every month they drink caffeine. You can already see that the number of days that seniors drink caffeine is higher than any of the others. But it also has a pretty large standard deviation, as does that for juniors. We want to know if at least one group of college students drinks more caffeine than the others. Dr. Laraway used the statistical program SPSS to answer this. Here's his ANOVA table output. According to this, which of the following would we do?